because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Here we go.
This is who I got. Every word of worship. Y'all know how we do it. We take it up and pray.
Give you a blessing, and especially after all these weeks. So we greet you, Nutley Abundant Life Worship Center. We greet you, all our friends. We greet you, all our visitors, in the name of Jesus. And we're going to open up with prayer. Even as cars are coming in, just look up here. This is where it's all going to be taking place. So we want you to pray along in your car. And we want the glory of the Lord to be in your car as well, as it is up here. Amen? Amen. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Father, we come to you in Jesus' name with grateful hearts this day. For this opportunity to be on these grounds to worship you in spirit and in truth. Father God, we're thankful for our people who have been so dedicated and who are coming out this morning and still coming out. And even those that have not been well, you have healed them in Jesus' name. Father, we pray this day for those that are still not well, that your supernatural touch will touch them right now and they will be delivered. In Jesus' name, we pray for those on the front lines. We pray for the doctors and nurses. We pray, oh God, for the firemen and the policemen, oh God, and those that are first aid squads. We pray for them, oh God, and we curse this disease that it has to go in the name of Jesus. And we pray for the governor of this state, oh God, that you'll touch his heart to open up all the churches for all the believers, oh God. And we pray for the president of the United States and his family and all those that are in leadership, every pastor this morning, every congregant, in Jesus' name. Thou art a good God. We're looking for great things this day. And we know that you will not fail us in any way. Whatever need is needed, oh God, that people, as they're praying in their cars right now, will feel your touch, would sense your presence, and the glory clouds will roll in. We thank you for all these things in the name of Jesus. And I hope everyone in your car is singing and praising the Lord. Now, I have a verse for you that the Lord gave me this week. It's found in Psalm 122, verse 1. You don't have to turn to it because you know it. And if you've never sung scripture, you're going to sing it with me this morning. Too high. I was glad when they said unto me, sing along. I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. So glad, so me to tell you something, and I've written down, I've been in prayer for this, and God has been showing me many things, and I want you to hear this. It's important that you know this, and you don't allow anyone to tell you anything different. God is essential. Yes! Jesus is essential. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is essential. God's word is essential. Our faith is essential. This house of worship that we gather in is essential. This pastor is essential. Every pastor is essential. Every one of you are essential. And so don't ever have anyone tell you that our faith and our church and our belief is unessential. So God is good. You just remember that to encourage yourself. Now I'm going to quickly give you guidelines. Please listen. This is our first time back, and we want to show respect to our neighbors and to town officials whom we have a great relationship with. And they have been very good to us and very cooperative to us. So, number one, no honking of your horns. Number two, sorry, there are no bathroom privileges, and that has been told to us. There can be no littering. The tithe envelopes, when you fill them out, you put them, if you don't want to get out, to put them on the windshield, the ushers will be by with baskets. If you are new for the first time, could you wave your hand out the window and you will be given cards to be filled out. Just throw that hand. There's two in the front row. Put that hand, throw it out. Three in the front row. Wave that hand and they're running to you. They'll give you a card, all right? And fill it out, and when the offering comes by, put it in, or if you want to put it on the windshield, put it on the windshield. People in the back are still waving. Everybody, this is for the welcome card. For the new people, raise your hands. We see you. One has it out their roof. Okay. No, it's not. It's a head. Okay. Amen. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Please follow the directions of the ushers at all times. In your car, you can wear a mask or you cannot wear a mask. That's in your car. Please do not get out of your car. And there'll be no gathering of people, no hugging, no touching, all that. When you are leaving the service today, the ushers will supervise you. Leaving today, we are leaving by both lanes at the same time. You will not back up. No car is to back up. Every car will pull forward. If there's any type of emergency and you have to leave, pull your car forward in the lane and then pull out. So when we're leaving in the two lanes, those that are going to turn right on Washington Avenue, you get in the lane that will turn right. Those that are going to be turning left on Washington Avenue will be on the lane turning left. Okay, I think we have that. There is no radio station going on now, but the service is being filmed live, and if you have your phone or your laptop, it's on Facebook. As far as YouTube, that will be uploaded after the service this morning, so you can catch that at home. Amen. Now we have Sister Tanya Binkowitz. She's going to blow the shofar three times, and after each blow, I want you to shout in your cars. Amen? Okay, I got it.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're going to worship Him this morning with songs of praise. Glory and hallelujah to the Lord. Thank you, Father.
up their woes. It is good to bless His holy name. I'm gonna bless His name. I'm gonna bless His name. I'm gonna bless His name. For we give thanks unto our Savior, and with a heart of gratitude we give Him praise. His mercy shall endure forever. I will worship Him all of my days. How good it is unto the Lord. How good it is to give thanks unto our God. For He heals the broken hearted, binding up their wounds. It is good to bless His holy name. I'm gonna bless His name.
Bless His name.
We're gonna bless His name. I'm gonna bless His name.
We give thanks to you, Lord.
For we give thanks unto our Savior. And with a heart of gratitude we give Him praise. His mercy shall endure forever. I will worship
His holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. How great are you, Lord? How great are you, Lord? Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name, dear Father. Hallelujah. How great is our God? We praise and worship you, O God. Hallelujah.
How great is our God? How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? And all will see how great. How great is our God. Sing with me. How great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
He's a name above all names.
How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God?
name above all names, name above all names, name above all names. You are worthy of all praise, and my heart will sing.
Hallelujah. Come on, can I get a hallelujah? Our God is a great God. He is greatly to be praised, so let's praise Him greatly. Our God is so great that there's not a sickness or a disease that can stand against Him. Hallelujah. You know, we use this scripture often for many things, but Ephesians 3:20 says, now unto Him, unto who? God, who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all you could ever ask or think, according to the power that's the Holy Spirit within you. How many are filled with the Holy Spirit today? Well, there's nothing then that God cannot do because of the Holy Spirit that's inside of you. So if you're going through a battle today, whether it's physical, mental, emotional, I want you right now, put your hand upon your head or upon the part of body that needs a healing. And we're going to pray and believe. Because the Word of God says, exceeding abundantly above all you could ever ask or think. Whatever you're thinking about or even asking God, He can do even greater. Let me have an amen. All right, let us pray. You have your hand on your head? You have your hand on the physical part of your body that needs a healing? Father, we come in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus. We thank You that You are a good God and You desire that Your people walk in good health. We know it is Your will. And we know that You are able to do exceeding abundantly above all we could ever ask or think. So no matter what we're asking for, what we're praying for, You could do even greater. So Lord, today we're believing for a greater touch. A greater touch. Right now, no sickness or disease can stand against our God and against the Holy Spirit-filled people. Lord, we're believing when we leave here today, there will be not one sick person among us. And even if we're standing in the gap for someone who's not here, they too will receive their touch. For today, we pray it and believe it by faith. For we pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to You, Lord God. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah. Our God is a healing God, a miracle working God. Hallelujah. It's good to be with you all today. This Thursday, we have our service, Bible study service. It will still be on Facebook and YouTube at 7 p.m. 7 p.m. this Thursday, still on Facebook or on YouTube. Tune in and connect with us online. And then next Sunday, We will continue with our drive-in service. It will be here in the parking lot at 10 a.m. unless the governor opens up church buildings. But we will possibly change into the sanctuary, but it will still be 10 a.m. So next Sunday, right now, we're planning on another drive-in service. Amen. At this time, we want to continue to give the Lord the glory, do his name, give him praise and honor. And we want to give our offerings and our tithes. And so I want you to please place your tithe or your offering in the basket with the ushers or on your windshield wiper. Amen. I have a scripture from the book of Psalms, Psalm 78. It says, yet he had commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven, had rained down manna on them to eat, and had given them the bread of heaven. Men are angels' food. He sent them food to the full. He caused an east wind to blow in the heavens, and by his power he brought in the south wind. He also rained meat on them like the dust, feathered fowl like the sands of the seas. So they ate and were well filled. Hallelujah. This is regarding the children of Israel. When they were wandering in the wilderness, God fed them and provided for them. Does it matter if we're in famine or in quarantine? God is our provider. Let's pray over our offering right now. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord God. You are the sovereign God. You are holy and awesome. And we thank you that we gather together in your name, the name of your Son, the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we thank you today that we can give our tithes, our offerings joyfully because you provide, Lord God. You are an awesome provider. You take good care of your children. Every good and every good, perfect gift, it comes down from you, Lord. And so today we thank you for all of our blessings. We thank you for all of our gifts. And we joyfully give an offering back unto you to glorify your name this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you. We give you glory, Lord. And I have a scripture personally. Each of the elders are going to come up and give a scripture. But my scripture is in Romans 8, 28. And it says, and he works all things out for good to them that are called according to his purpose. Amen. He works all things out for good to them who love him and are called according to his purpose. Romans 8, 28. God bless you, church.
And my calling is to wipe the microphone. It's a great calling, amen. Amen. I don't know about the rest of you, but how many of you have missed being hugged? Come on, I think the enemy has tried to tell us that we can't receive hugs from one another. So air hugs to the people in the congregation today. Air hugs to all of you, because we serve a God who is able to wrap himself around us. Amen. In Psalm 16, it says, your pleasant path leads me to pleasant places. I am overwhelmed by the privileges that come with following you, for you have given me your best. How many of you have his best this day? Come on, people of God. We may be sitting in our cars, but our God has given us the best. The way you counsel and correct us makes us want to praise you more. For your whispers in the night give us wisdom, showing us what to do next. Because you are close to me and always available, my confidence will not be shaken. For I experience the wraparound presence of my God every moment. Give me a hands out the window if you experience the wraparound presence of your God every moment. My heart and soul explode with joy, full of glory Even my body will rest confident and secure. For you did not abandon us, nor will you allow your Holy One to experience corruption. For you bring continual resurrection and revelation life that brings us face to face with you. Right now, surround yourself, hug yourself, and receive the hug of the Master this day with his wraparound presence that satisfies. In Jesus' name, amen. She's a little slow. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. He is so good. He is good in quarantine. He is good in every moment of every day. In Esther chapter 4, verse 14, it says, "For if you remain silent now, then relief and deliverance will not come to the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Who knows if you haven't come to the kingdom for such a time as this?" We are in quarantine, but you can't quarantine our spirits. And the people of God need each other because we are the body of Christ. And when you leave today, tell everyone you see that you are together with your body and you felt whole and you felt united, because it's Jesus by his Holy Spirit. Our Heavenly Father unites us as one body. And I thank everyone for coming. People were telling me there'd only be a few cars. And I'm looking around at every saint of God. And I thank you because you have made my day and my quarantine, because we are one in Christ and I worship his name. Thank you for coming and God bless you.
Amen. Good morning. God bless you all. You know, it's funny because we know what each other looks like, but then we really have to look at one another, because with these masks, you're not too sure who's behind the mask until you really look in their eyes, right? And the cars, too. Some of the cars you recognize and the other cars you don't recognize. But the scripture is Isaiah 43. I'm in verses 1, 2, 18, and 19. And this is what we need to start doing, is speaking the word. "Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior." Verse 18. "Do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." God is doing a new thing. Here we are in quarantine to bring down any idols that we have made, that we did not put God first in our lives. This is so we will draw closer to him. And his promise for us, whether we're on the mountaintop in difficult times or in the valley, he will be with us. He will carry us through. He cares for you. He will guide you, and he will never abandon you. Amen? Amen. Amen.
I want to welcome each and every one of you today as well, and we're thankful to the Lord that we're able to do this drive-in service. I know it's not what we'd like to do. We'd like to be in the sanctuary, and I'm praying, by Lord willing, by next week we will be back in the sanctuary. If not, we'll be in the parking lot. we're going to continue to do what we believe the Lord wants us to really do. Now, I want to share with you the scriptures today. Are you ready to hear the word of God? If you are,
yes.
Honk your horn once. All right, there we go. Okay, I'll take that as an amen. Yes, all right. I want to tell you, first of all, that tomorrow is Memorial Day. And we want to show gratitude for the brave men and women who have been very heroic in the sacrifice of our freedom. And I want you to realize this, that we need to pray for all the families that have lost loved ones through COVID-19, and that the peace of the Lord will rest upon them. Amen. But we are thankful for every person in the military, and tomorrow you need to be thinking about them, and we need to be praying for the families that have lost loved ones because of the war or wars. I want to take you to a text today that I'm sure you know, but at the same time, I want to share it with you because it's something very important. My text is in the book of Philippians chapter 2, and I'm going to catch this with verse number 8 and verse number 8 and take you right through to verse number 11. Let's see if we can put the glasses on and have a mask hanging around my ears at the same time. Here it is. And being found in the fashion as a man, talking about Jesus now, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name that is above every other name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and of things in the earth and of things under the earth. Verse number 11. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Throughout history and our lives here on earth, names always meant something. The name, when you hear a name, something pops up within your own mind. Like, for instance, if I was to give you the name George Washington, you would immediately know he was the first president, he was a military general, he was a statesman, and he was a founding father. If I was to tell you the name Abraham Lincoln, you would remember quickly that he was the 16th president, and he was the man who pulled us through the American Civil War. If I jump out of that area and go to the Bible, if I was to mention Noah, you would immediately think of the first cruise ship that was built in the desert because of impending judgment which was coming upon the earth. If I was to name for you Moses, you would remember this movie, The Ten Commandments, and that he led Israel out of Egypt, and they marched for 40 years in the wilderness, which should have only taken but just 40 days. Now, I want you to realize something. George Washington's name was given to him by his mother. Abraham Lincoln's name was given to him by his mother. Noah, no doubt the same thing, by a mother. Moses, the same thing, given by a mother. But I want you to know that the name of Jesus wasn't given to him by his mother. Mary didn't give him her name. He gave him the name which was above every name, the name of Jesus. It's a divinely appointed name. This name is divine. This name is glorious. This name brings us into position to see the glory of the Lord in a name that was given him most abundantly by the Lord God Almighty. Now, why did Jesus be named Jesus Christ? The name Jesus means salvation, but it also means deliverance. It is a name that breaks the natural and brings you into the realm of the supernatural. It's a divinely appointed name. It's a name that God has given for you and I to call upon. And when we call upon that name, many divinely things happen. Now, the name also will require that every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow. We have been going through the coronavirus for the last 4 months, 3 to 4 months, and that name coronavirus has caused many knee to bow. It's caused many lives to be destroyed. Many people now in New Jersey were over 90,000, slowly passing to 100,000 of people who have died from a name called coronavirus or COVID-19. But I want to tell you, when you mention the name coronavirus, it's an earthly name. It's been given by some scientists or doctors. But I want to tell you, the name that's greater than coronavirus is the name of Jesus. When you're sick and diseased, and when you're in trouble, downhearted, discouraged, or feeling rejection or depressed, you don't call on coronavirus. You call upon the name of Jesus, because that's the name that will set you free. That's the name that will bring joy to your heart. That's the name that will encourage you and bring you to the reality of the divinely appointed blessing of Jesus Christ himself. Thirdly and lastly, that name is a name where every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Every name shall confess. Every scientist, every doctor, every individual on the face of the earth will come to the grips with the place where they are, that they will have to say that the biggest and greatest name, the name that is above, the name that is divine, the name that is holy, the name that will cause your tongue to utter divinely instituted or divinely glory, which is the name of Jesus Christ. You see, John came into the world, and when the Apostle John came into the world, John declared Jesus is the name whereby men and women will be saved and will be given life eternal. Listen, we've gone through a tremendous 3 to 4 months, and we have been wondering where we're going and what's going to happen. I want to tell you, God is still in control. I want to tell you, Jesus Christ is still at the right hand of God the Father. Crank down your window and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you will notice very quickly that the name of Jesus brings life and life eternal. I want you to know this. They're telling us that there are so many cardiac arrests. It's up 800%. 600 doctors are saying it's not good to be shut into a home for long. And now they're starting to confess that to be true. But I want to tell you, even though you've been sheltered in a home, there's one thing they can't control is your tongue. Because your tongue can give praise to God, and your tongue can lift the name of Jesus. And as you're lifting the name of Jesus, when hell hears the name of Jesus, it falls prostrate to the floor. But when angels hear it, they bow and begin to shout praises. But when the church hears the name of Jesus, we begin to sing, there's no other name under heaven whereby men can be saved. Jesus is the sweetest name I know. Every knee shall bow. every tongue shall confess Jesus is Lord. If you believe that, honk your horn. Amen. The name of Jesus gives hope. I want to tell you, some people say there's no tomorrow. Oh no, there is a tomorrow. You've got hope in your heart. Tomorrow was made for you and I. We can look forward to it. The name of Jesus also brings health. It brings health. It also brings happiness. So as you're standing today before, or as you're sitting today in your car, where we may be quarantined to a certain extent, but I want to tell you, there's joy in our hearts. We're getting ready to sing a tremendous song. And the song is, we've got the victory. We've got the joy. We've got the praise. We've got the goodness of the Lord in our lives. And God never said he would leave us or forsake us. The Bible is very clear. And I want you to know that it is well with our soul. Tomorrow is going to be a great day. Tomorrow is a great day because of the hope that resides in Jesus Christ. And so therefore, I want you to know your day is brighter tomorrow than it was yesterday. I want to tell you, your future is greater in front of you than that which was behind you. Don't look forward to death. Look forward to life. Look forward to the joy of the Lord and allow the Lord to bless your life. If you're here today and you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I want to pray with you right now at this time. And if you're not a believer, I want you to make Jesus Lord of your life today. So right while you sit in your car, pray this prayer with me. It's an invitational prayer. You're inviting Jesus to come into your heart and your life. You can crank down your window and you can pray it out loud, and everybody can pray it. Come on, pray it with me out loud. Oh, eternal Father, I come to you in Jesus' name. I confess I am a sinner and I cannot save myself. But you, Lord Jesus, came into this world 2,000 years ago looking for me. And today, in the parking lot of Nutley Abundant Life Worship Center, I'm inviting you to come into my heart. Forgive me of my sin. Wash me in your precious blood. I receive you now. I'm going to follow you and obey you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Our sister Jackie Burke is coming to sing for you a song of praise.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Just the voices. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. When peace like a river attendeth my way, whatever my
It is well.
Hallelujah.
It is well with my soul. It is well.
Try to buffet, though trials should come.
Let this blessed assurance control
my helplessness.
a great song. It is well with my soul. Amen. And it should be well. I'm going to pray the closing benediction on you, and then the ushers will guide you out of the parking lot. Two lanes, not one. Two lanes, both lanes going out, and this way you'll not be in here long. All right. I just want to remind you, Thursday night, 7 o'clock on YouTube and Facebook, and as well that if the governor gives us the right to open the church, we will be inside next week. If not, we'll be in the parking lot. Exit one row at a time, cars. Pay attention to the ushers. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you for coming and being a part of this drive-in service. And happy Memorial Day to all of you. And now, our gracious Father, we thank you for this service and for the blessing of the Lord that's been upon it. And Father, we pray that now you will keep your people. If there's anyone discouraged in this group, Holy Spirit, encourage them right now. If there's anyone depressed, oh God, encourage them right now. Let them not be downcast, but let them lift up their heart before the Lord and receive a fresh infilling of your presence in their life. I pray the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And now unto him that's able to keep you from falling, who will present you faultless before the majesty of his glory. I pray this in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, on the authority of Jesus' name. If you enjoyed the service, come on, honk your horn one more time.
I'm waiting up for you. Savior.